A question I'm often asked is, other than the Cirrus, have I looked at other options? And the answer to that is absolutely yes. While we all want a brand new airplane, there are other great values in the market. And today, I'm going to welcome you guys, come on board with my friend, as we hop on his Bonanza. He just bought this plane. And speaking of which, here comes my friend. So come on aboard. Brought you his brand new Tesla Model Y, just like mine. What's up, buddy?
Hi, John.
Good morning. How you doing?
Good morning. How do you feel like doing today?
Yo, I feel great. This is my friend Braulio. Braulio's been a pilot for a few years, and however, you're a brand new airplane owner, right?
Absolutely. I can say that.
And you have a 1980 Bonanza?
Yeah, Bonanza F33A.
F33. I've flown the Bonanza before. In my opinion, it's one of the best built plane. Before Cirrus came on the scene, I think they were the reigning champion in general aviation. I know that you were trained in Cirrus.
I trained in the Cessna 172. That was my primary airplane, both in class DG1000 and the steam gauges. You know, I prefer a G1000. When I tried the Cirrus, I was, let's say, two-thirds in my training.
And you were what?
Two-thirds in terms
two-thirds.
Of planning process, yeah.
Yep.
And when I tried it, I tried the Cirrus SR20 with my instructor, and I was blown away, you know, the differences in terms of stability, the power, the comfort, you know, how everything was just laid out.
Compared to the 172, right?
Compared to the 172, yes. Yeah. The 172, the, you know, the wind plays with it a lot. Mm-hmm. So the Cirrus is definitely a lot more stable.
And I know a lot of viewers are currently student pilots, and you guys are training in the 172. I think most of us came up through the path of even earlier than the 172, the 152, and it is a great plane. Not to knock the 172, but when you get a chance, try to fly a low-wing plane, right? Whether it's a Piper or a Cirrus or a Bonanza, give a shot. The especially in the air, in the wind, crosswind situation, the plane actually feels quite different.
Mm-hmm. It's a better lander. The low wing airplane definitely is a better lander. What I told my instructor after that first flight, I said, I don't want to fly it anymore because I'm going to get spoiled. And if you want to really become a pilot that you know how to deal with every situation, you need to work it out.
Right.
You cannot just get it easy until I get my certificate, because you're going to be spoiled.
Right.
You know, it will be unfair just to switch to something so much easier. No, I needed to work it out. I needed to really fight with the wing. I needed to, you know, to really earn my certificate the proper way. You know, and once I finished and I got my certificate, that was in August 2018, then I switched to the Cirrus, and I started flying the SR20 only.
Mm-hmm. I know we went through 172, then you finished, you got your pilot's license, and you flew the Cirrus SR20, you loved it.
Yeah.
So how long was it between you getting your pilot's license till the time when you bought the Bonanza, and how did you make that decision?
I love the Cirrus. The problem is Cirrus is very expensive. It's definitely not in my budget range.
Mm-hmm.
So I couldn't go for the Cirrus. I needed to go for something that will give me quality, will be a performer, it will mm-hmm. be a reliable airplane, something that I will enjoy flying, that will definitely bring all these characteristics at mm-hmm. my price budget. And right there was no other plane, it was the Bonanza.
Did you look at the used Cirrus market?
I did look at the used Cirrus market,
okay.
And I wasn't very crazy about the very old Cirruses.
Correct.
With the Abadine.
Right, with the Abadine system, and then the old MCUs, right? Because I think anybody who's looking for a Cirrus, if you are going to look at the Avidyne market, I think with serial number 1663, which is the generation 2, that's when they updated the MCU. And the old ones, I think we talked about this, was the electronic or electrical gremlins that the plane had. And when did you buy the plane?
I bought the plane in August last year. And then after that, I took it to a lot of upgrades and changes.
And also, your timing was pretty good. Would you mind telling the audience a little bit more about the cost of the plane, how much you paid for it, how much you put into it, what do you think the plane's worth now?
Well, when the airplane was being offered for $195, which is a little bit over what the market was before that, but you know, the airplane looked really great, had a, you know, great condition, one owner. I paid $168.
Okay. What's then the CDA, your purchase price? And then how much did all the upgrades and everything cost you?
I put about 40K, I would say, in upgrades. So the airplane came out about
200.
I was at 200.
200. 200, $210,000. And this airplane will cruise at?
Cruise speed, you're going to cruise about 150, 160, 170.
So for $210,000, you get a wonderful plane that is well built. And while it's not the latest and greatest like the Cirrus, however, it will do what, 80, 90% of what the Cirrus's performance will do, right?
Yeah, the SR22.
SR22, right? We're not even talking about the SR20. This thing will blow an SR20 away.
Yeah, no, definitely.
We just got to the airport. We're gonna untie the plane and
pre-flight,
and
get ready to go.
Let's go.
Altimeter 29901.
Grumman Tiger, one of my favorite plane. Yeah. That's also another great plane.
Yeah.
For anyone who's looking.
I heard it performs really, really good. Long Island Tower, Bonanza 6733 Yankees. Holding short runway B4 at 33 left at B4, ready to go.
Beach 6733 Yankee, Long Island Tower, runway 33 left. Surface takeoff.
33 left, clear or take off, 33 Yankee. Okay, let's go. Okay. Okay, instruments in the green. Airspeed is alive. 70. Number runway remaining, gear up.
Beach 33 Yankee, contact departure slot.
Contact departure, 33 Yankee. Your departure, Bonanza, 6733 Yankee, just off Islip, climbing 2000.
I'm 6733 Yankee, near departure, radar contact, climb and change 4500.
4500, we're going direct, 33 Yankee.
That's really bad. We have moderate turbulence at 6,000. I wonder if you could give us higher at 8.
Renata, Nata, Sierra Lima, stand by. What kind of turbulence you picking up, sir?
Light to moderate chop at 6,000. It was smoother at 8 by Nata, Sierra Lima.
Renata, Sierra Lima, roger, stand by.
Very bouncy day today.
Yeah.
So earlier we're talking about the performance of Bonanza relative to Cirrus, right? I mean, we all know that Cirrus is a great, great plane. It looks great. But Bonanza also looks great.
Yeah.
It's kind of picking between Marilyn Monroe and Grace Kelly, which one like better, right?
Yeah.
Both are beautiful, beautiful planes. Now, for what you pay for this plane, this is a great bang for the buck, would you say?
I agree.
You know? We're doing about how much? 130?
I'm doing close to 130. I reduced significantly because of the wing.
Today's a very bumpy day, so reduced down to maneuvering speed. And at this point, I'll tell you, it absorbs turbulence really well.
Yeah, it performs very well. It feels very solid. Compared to other airplanes, you know, you feel more comfortable.
Absolutely. Sending this thing, it feels like it's a tank.
Yeah, it is, and They are made utility.
They're all made utility category, that's right.
Correct. Two spars on the wings.
And you upgraded this to Garmin 750.
It had a Garmin 750.
Okay.
I added the wireless.
Even though it's a six-pack, but 750 is like a mini G1000.
Yeah, it has the best of both worlds. And then I complemented it with an Aera 660.
Uh-huh.
That will give me basically a second screen.
And you have the fly stream car, so you can transfer the fly plan to the Garmin 750.
Yes.
Which is great, so convenient.
Very convenient.
135.9.
So tell us about finding this blue knob. For a lot of Cirrus drivers, we don't even know what the heck that is. Obviously, all kidding aside, that's a prop control. Do you feel it's nice to have the prop control?
Because you can have a better manual control of the airplane. I do like it.
Sure.
It feels you're more in control.
Do you usually fly Richard Peak or Lena Peak on this?
On this one, I fly Richard Peak because if you notice, the cylinder number one, it gets a little hotter. So because the cylinders are not that stable, I prefer to fly Richard Peak because it's safer for me.
That's a very good valid point. It has lots of room.
We have the weather.
So brother, is this typically a five-seater?
It's a five-seater. There is another seat in the back. I removed it because I obviously don't need it because it's basically for small kids. And there is a 120-pound weight limitation. And this airplane, as you consume fuel, the CG goes aft.
Oh, that's right.
So this is a limitation on these airplanes. That somehow got better corrected with the Bonanza 836. So you always have to be mindful about that because you can take off with a forward CG, but if you go far, as the fuel gets consumed, your CG goes backwards, so you have to be always aware of that limitation.
Right, for sure. And what's a typical useful load on this plane?
It's a 1,050.
1,050?
Yeah.
This thing's useful load, pretty good. It's almost as good as a Cirrus G5 and on, right? Because I think the Cirrus uses like 1,100 pounds, depends on what's equipped on there.
Yeah, this is pretty good, and you know, you have a 80-gallon tank here, and 74 usable.
80-gallon tank, 74 usable, and what's your typical endurance and fuel burn?
My fuel burn normally is about 14, 15 gallons an hour.
Okay.
On cruise.
So that comes out to be about 5-6 hours of endurance.
Correct.
It's more than what your bladder can do.
Yes. It's really becoming bumpier, no? As we get into rough terrain.
Yeah, because you have all that.
6 Fox, Lima, contact New York, approach 118.12.
We're going to be in for some bumps.
33 Yankee, contact New York, approach 132.75.
132.75, 33 Yankee, thank you. New York approach, Bonanza, 6733 Yankee, level 4500.
7733 Yankee, New York approach, the Poughkeepsie altimeter is 29 or 9 or 2.
9 or 9 or 2, 33 Yankee. So what Bradio doing is, as he's setting up the plane, we decide to turn our plane around. Instead of meeting with our friends for lunch, as we continue to progress our trip toward Saratoga, and the turbulence is just getting worse and worse and worse. It was actually an extreme turbulence reported about 5 miles east of us by Chester VOR at 5,700 feet. So, out of abundance for caution, we're just gonna head back because it's not worth it. We texted our friend. Unfortunately, we won't be able to meet up with him, but you know, it's better to be on the ground wishing you're up here, then be up here wishing you're on the ground. And this is pretty turbulent right now.
Oh, yeah.
So I think it's the right decision. Anyway, so. The thing about this plane is that, unlike a Cessna 172 that fly, the yoke and everything else don't feel with a very big null in the center.
Yeah.
It's solid, right?
Very solid, you see? We're getting a lot of turbulence.
We're getting a lot of turbulence, and you can pretty much trim it to fly by itself. That's how good this plane is.
Yep.
But you do need to use a little bit of muscle. It's a little bit heavier than a 172.
Oh, a lot heavier.
But the feel is very precise.
But you know, it's a big surprise. When you compare the 172 to the 182, the 182 is very heavy on the controls, especially the elevator is really heavy. This airplane, besides that, you know, the size and the weight of the airplane, actually
it's
light on the controls.
That's
an advantage.
Have you flown a Mooney before?
No, I haven't.
Mooney is very heavy. Mooney feels like you're flying a truck.
Yeah, I heard that.
I think we made a good decision coming back.
Yeah, I think so. You know, there's a limit to everything.
If I was by myself and maybe I'll push it through if I need to get there, but at some point, this is just not fun. You know, we're over the sound right now. We're getting tossed around, right?
Yeah, it shouldn't be that way.
Zero to maintain 4,000.
Approaching 2,000 feet.
6733 Yankee Wind 31017 gust 27 runway 33 left clear to land.
33 left clear to land. 33 Yankee.
Three Yankee, safe parking.
Heritage 33 Yankee.
Bonanza 33 Yankee, left at Bravo 2, contact ground.
Bravo 2 on ground, 33 Yankee.
I don't get nauseous, I'm even getting a bit nauseous.
No, I didn't get nauseous either, but I mean, you know, the more we go, the bumpier it's becoming.
It's just that this plane is going to have no issue taking the turbulence, right?
Yeah.
But it's just not fun anymore.
No.
We tried it, we made an effort for it. Yeah, I think that's good, ADM.
Well, we walked away from another one.
Yeah.
Didn't get to Saratoga, but we're back on the ground safely.
I'm glad we did that.
We did. The wind's crazy. It's absolutely nuts. So what is this thing called? This is called a what?
It's
a sidewinder.
Red line sidewinder.
Red line sidewinder. Okay. Because this is what Bonanza owners like to use. Cirrus owners like to use best tugs.
If you have a hanger, definitely, you know, best tugs.
Best tugs is great. We love our best tugs.
But if you don't have a hanger, where are you going to put it?
Right.
You move it out, and you're done.
Very cool. How much is this tug?
Like 2,500, I think.
Ah, it's a lot cheaper than the best tug.
Yeah, definitely.
But I don't care what you say, I still like my best tug better.
No, it is better. You know, for somebody that doesn't have a hanger,
yeah.
Where are you gonna put it?
That's true, absolutely true.
So, you know.
And this is, they make one for the Cirrus, right? Because Cirrus
they
has the wheel pan.
Every airplane.
Uh-huh.
And I guess one of the last things we can tell the viewers is that, you know, the old saying, what is an expensive airplane? An expensive airplane is the cheap airplane, right? So if anyone who's looking for a plane, go out to the market, find the best example that you can afford. The chances are that when you find a clean plane, it will cost you less.
And you will never look back. I can guarantee you that.
That's correct.